Welcome guys, let's start to design this simple part in our CAD software. So here you can see a solid model of this back cover of trial monitor. And actually for creating this we have to use two workbenches like surface design and part design also. So at bottom you can see a orthographic views of this solid model and all dimensions. So let's start to create this part in our CAD software. So first of all open CAD, go to start. And first go to shape and generate to shape this and make sure press ok. And as usual we are not using this plane because we are creating our own plane to make a existing. So select this all and hide this and call one point which is act as origin and insert axis system to this point. Now our first work is done. We have created this axis system. Let's start to design this part. So first of all you will create this rectangle here. So actually this square part. So go to sketch positioning and select this ZY plane. Origin as this projected point, orientation is parallel to this line. And create one center rectangle from this profile tab and make sure the center of this rectangle is this. And no dimensions for this only is 100 and 100. So give here 100, give here also 100. Now exit to the sketch workbench. And before creating surface, make sure you are in geometrical shape only because we are creating surface only in geometrical shape. And now go to surface tab here and use extrude command here. And extrude this part in reverse direction and increase up to 50 dimension we can take and add this sketch. And now we have to create this side view. So go to sketch positioning, select this ZX plane from here, make sure origin point is this, orientation is parallel to this line. Now create one arc here. For creating arc, go to profile tab and go to this here and like this like structure we have to create. Make sure this to this it is half of this part which it is present at 50. Yes, this also it is present at 50. And bottom and this to this dimension is given as 22 and upper is 12. This length upper is at 12. And the radius value for this arc is 125. Now our this 2D sketch is completed fully constrained. Now exit this 2D sketch workbench. Now again select this extrude and make sure you have your mirror extract up to here. You want this profile, make it pure It's okay. Now this part we don't want actually. This surface is we don't want. So go to split command here. In this operation type you can say split. And whichever we don't want, we have to click first. So we don't want this. Now click on this other and make sure the preview part is gone. So in this preview you can see this surface is removed. So make it on the side. Now this part is removed. Make it remove. Okay. And head this stage. And for creating this sketch, you see actually it is auxiliary view. So this auxiliary view you can see here. So for creating this, we have to draw one line here. So go to sketch positioning, select this ZX plane again. Go to origin, create a contest this. Parallel to this line and draw one line here from this to this. Make sure the dimensions of this line to step from this line. Dimension is -60 and also angle is also 0 from here is 20. And from bottom it is present at 60 mm. Now what? Where we want to take this. So and you can see length of we have to tune. So from this to this some angle also given. So here is given somewhat like 9.5. Here you can see the value is given as 9.5. Need to delete this. Go once again on this. This make it vertical. Yeah, horizontal is perfect. And it is actually 9.5. Now this sketch is completed. Just exit this workbench. And now we have to create first of all here plane here. So to create here upon plane, go to plane command and make sure we have to choose plane type as normal to curve. So this first of all curve and this as a point. So first of all we will create an entry here and go to sketch positioning and select this plane. Make sure to move this point as this our origin point and parallel to this line. So here you can see small rectangle we have to create first. The value for small rectangle is 50 height and 50 length. So create a rectangle, yes, actually center rectangle from this origin point. Just some lightings are coming, so go to view here and go to lighting command. Select lighting light here. And length of this circle is, sorry, height of this rectangle is 40. And length of this rectangle is 50. Now this rectangle is created. Just exit this workbench. Now go to again create new plane here. Go to plane command. Make sure you select a normal to curve. Select this and this as a curve and this as a point. Now select this plane. Make sure to give origin and orientation should be proper. Actually, we have to create it here. And select center rectangle also here and make sure the center is coming at origin. Draw a rectangle like this and actual dimension for this is 60 and 65. So 60 is height. And 65 is breadth. Breadth is 65. Length and breadth are given. Now edit this workbench. Now we have to create multi-section here. You have to use multi-section here. Before creating this, make sure to have this all plane. Now go to multi-section command here. And this surface we can see in the surface tab. Go to multi-section surface and select this as the first section, this as second section, and make sure your closing point are same side and this and this side and with same direction. Now go to spine command here and we are using this line as a spine. Make it preview. You can see our sketch is completed, but some edges are coming like this. So you can go to coupling here and make it vertices and now make it preview. Now you can see my exam corner edges are created here. Now press OK. And we don't want this inside part. So first of all, have these sketches and this curve also. Now go to trim command here from this operation tab and apply out of this clip and select first of all this and this surface. Actually you can see here this comes somewhat only up to this, so we have to increase this surface also. So go to extrapolate command in this operation tab and select this edge of surface and this as a surface to extrapolate and make here propagation mode as point continuity. So by using this point continuity on edges are actually put, so we get some value up to 15 and we can take and make it preview. Press OK. Now make sure to join this and this surface. Go to vertical join command and select this all. So you can see our tree it is joined up. Now go to trim, select this surface and this surface. Now you can see our inner part is removed and this outer part is removed, but we don't want this, we want other side. Make it auto save this, we want this other side. Now make it view and press OK. Now you can see our part is created, this part is created and this surface part is created. Now make sure to close this and this front also. So close, and if you want to close, to go to fill command here, select this, this. So here close onto this curve, make it preview, press OK. Now same we have to do here also, this line, and this to change, this and this. Now this surface is already closed. Now change our workbench to part design. For changing this, go to start, mechanical design, part design. Because we have to make this surface of close part, and make sure before going to this close surface, you are in a part body design workbench, because the solid modeling we are doing only in part body and surfacing we are doing only in geometrical sector. Now here you can see surface based features command. Now so fly out to this, here you can see close surface. Also you can see from this also go to insert surface based feature and select close surface here and make sure you are in part body object. Now select this surface, but before that we are not drawing this all surface, so again go to generate shape and again make sure you are in geometrical shape. Now go to join command here and select this face and this face and make here distance propagation. So you have selected all solid and make it here OK. Now go to again part define body and make sure to change the workbench also. Now you have to use float surface here, and our float surface is created here. Go to view, so the tool, and go to hide here. Make sure to hide all surfaces. And you can see how simple the part is created here. So let's start to make hello for this TV. Actual shell value for this is, you can see here, okay, shell value for this view, you can see you can do 1 mm. So go to shell command and select this front face only and value is as 1 mm. Now you can see this part is shelled, but before making hollow we are giving fillet, so delete this first shape, give some fillets here. First of all, we should mark the fillets value. So here we have to give two radius value for this and this. Now select this corner, rotate this part and select this and radius value is 4. Sorry, actually radius value is 2. And next is for this also we have to do for means this all sides we have to do 4. This also we have to do 4. So double click to this previous also. Make sure to do this and for because this value is also 2. And this is 3.5. Go to fillet again. Skip this corner. This corner, this part we have choose this face. So go to this multi output and remove this. Make sure to be proper. Again, we have make this mistake. Make sure to be only this edge value for this is 3.5. And this also we are giving 2. Clicking on this, select this. This. So we are mistakenly click again this face. Now press OK. And another also. And this corner we are also going to fill it. Still fill it in this fifty. Just we are checking it is correct or wrong. No, it is wrong. So just give it to 2. Now our all fillets are given. And now go to share command. Select this current page. Value for this part taken is 1. Now you can see the exact coil type structure is created here. So we are changing our shear edges smooth. So you can see our smooth part is created. This back permanent is created by using surface design and part design.